Hi and welcome to another video looking at how you use Android on a tablet PC. And this is Android 4.0, which is the very latest version of Android, but you may well have an earlier version of Android, and I'll just point out where things might look a little bit different as we go along. In this video, we're looking really at how you download applications to your tablet PC or ebooks or videos. We can do that via the Android market. Now, most kind of higher end tablets will have the Android market directly on the tablet. If you haven't got that, there are other options a way around it, but we're not going to show those in that video. So if we jump into the Android market, you're probably going to be greeted with a screen like this. If you aren't, the other option you may be greeted with is something that looks like this, where it's just a list of applications or ebooks, etc. Rather than this kind of more stylized version where you may well see some more sort of advertised featured applications, ebooks, etc. Now it's quite easy just to sort of scroll back and forth down this. There's a few things here we can do some quick links into kind of key areas, like this area here gives you games if you set that tile. There's certain movies they're kind of preempting here. Some other applications, ebooks, etc., that they're kind of promoting to you. We've also got down the right hand side here the apps, books, movies, and kind of an option to click one of these tiles and see more. So if we jump into the app section, again we're kind of given this kind of tiled effect window which you can skim up and down on. There's a few areas like editor's choice, games, staff choice for tablets. Some of this stuff helps you kind of find some of the better applications that are available for your Android tablet. Now the other thing here though is you can also flick left and right and jump to some other alternative. So this is the kind of featured screens. If you jump to the left, you get a list of categories where you can kind of quickly jump to a curated list which is much more around the kind of category that you're looking for. So for example, we've got categories like games, books and reference, business, comics, communication, education, entertainment, finance, health, the list goes on. So it's really up to you as to what you're looking for in terms of the categorization. But if you jump to the right, you then got some other options which are more the kind of the best and most popular applications. So for example, here we've got the top paid apps, and again you can kind of skim down these and it gives you the kind of up to as many as you want in terms of the top 100, etc., or more. You've also got the top free applications. Again, you can skim down all of these. These are the top grossing applications. We've got the top new applications that are paid. Similarly, you've got the top new free applications. And you've got the trending applications, so the stuff that's trending at the moment. So it's pretty simple, actually, if you want to have a look at one of these apps. Let's just look in the free stuff here, because it's a bit sort of easier to pick something up here. Let's just pick a game, say, Bubble Shoot. Okay, what you're presented here when you tap on something is a lot more information about that, that application. So first of all, you've got some screenshots around here, which you can kind of look back and forth on. You've got a description that teaches you a bit more about how to play that, and you can expand that description, find out some more information on there. What's new usually covers if there's been any recent upgrades to this this application. Some ratings and reviews, how many people have rated it in the 5-star category, and some actual comments that, again, you can see all and see a lot more information on those. Let's tap out of that. There's also some kind of user generated suggestions, so users who looked at this also viewed other applications. It's a bit of an easier way to quickly find stuff that you might like. And there's some other bits and pieces on here. You've also got things like the people who actually made this application, if they've made some other applications, some links to their web pages, you can email them directly. Just here centrally as well, we've got the number of reviews and the kind of star rating for this application, so it's a quick way of checking the quality. But you've also got the download box here, so let's say we want to download this. You just tap on the download box, it gives you this kind of pop-up here that tells you what it's going to modify on your tablet, so just confirm you accept that, and you can kind of expand that if there's some other bits and pieces there. It gives you some more details if you want to click on the sort of more details bit here, the kind of little arrow to the right. But generally, I think if you've got this far, you're probably just going to press this button here, which is accept and download. So let's do that. Straight away you get this kind of little status update here, which tells you how big it is and how much it's downloaded at that stage. At that stage, you actually might have noticed the X there, so you can stop it and cancel it from downloading at that stage if you want. But it's now got to a point where it's ready to it's downloaded, it's ready to either open or be uninstalled. So at this point, you might want to uninstall it before you open it, but let's just go straight in and open it. And immediately it jumps straight into there and into the application. Now we're not going to go into that. I'm going to just take you back to the Android market where we were and pick up from there. But you can see downloading an application is pretty straightforward. Now if we back out of this, let's jump right back to the market here. Now that was applications. Let me take you into books here. It's a similar setup really. You know, again we've got this kind of featured screen with some of the kind of books that they're promoting on that. You can jump this way and see categories of books. Again, lots of different categories, similar setup to we saw in apps. And if you go to the right here, where we've got things like new arrivals in fiction, so again, lots of different books, the kind of effectively the kind of charts of the books. We've also got the new arrivals in non-fiction, top selling, top rated. Again, you can just flick down these, top free books. It's all pretty straightforward. So again, downloading a book, you just click on it. This is a free book, Pride and Prejudice. So we're just going to have a quick look at that. Again, you've got reviews here. You've got a suggestion of users also viewed other books. So it gives you some help with finding some other alternative stuff if you want that. You've got other books by that author. You've got ratings, all that sort of stuff. So let's say we just want to open that. Now, to do that, you'll need the latest Google Books application to read this book. So I'm going to OK that. It's going to take me to the Android Market version of Google Books. OK, so Google Books, it gives me a bit more information there. Here's actually, I mentioned earlier that there's a video where some of these applications will have a video that will talk you through the app. So I'm just going to click that, and it takes you into YouTube and gives you a little video about the application and shows you what it does. Now, I'm not going to show you all of that in this video, but you can see what I mean. Now I'm going to install this Google Books application. It comes back again with the do I give permission to the different things that it's going to access on the app. I'm going to accept and download that. It's downloading again. It's showing me how much is completed. I've got the little X if I wanted to stop it at that stage. It's still downloading. Now installing. Different messaging coming up as we go along just to tell you where we're at. It's ready to go. Let's open that. Not sync at this stage, but yeah, it's just given me now the books I've said to download. And now, fairly simple thing actually. Let's jump into that Pride and Prejudice, and you've got a kind of fairly standard ebooks application here where you can click. It's just loading it up at the moment, so just taking a bit longer than expected. And you just click through pages. It's fairly straightforward. You can actually do a few other bits in here, like selecting words and looking at dictionary definitions and all that sort of stuff, but I'm not going to go into that at this stage. So if we jump back now, let's jump back into the Android market. So we saw what happened there with books. So the last bit of the Android market for me to show you is movies. So these are movie rentals. Again, we've got the featured page. Again, we can click to the left and see the categories here. So there's less in the movie, so action, adventure, animation, comedy, drama, documentary, family, and horror. Again, we turn right here. We've got the top rentals kind of chart. So pretty straightforward. It's all just loading up there. We've got new releases. We've got, oh, that's it actually in the movies. So that gives you a sort of a brief idea of finding stuff out there. And again, a similar setup. Let's say you want to actually download something from this. Oops. Let's click on something here. You can rent those movies. You've got a little trailer here if you want to see the actual trailer. Again, it takes you to YouTube to see the trailer. I'm not going to take you through that again, but let's back up. You've got a synopsis. You can extend that. You can look at the user reviews of this. You can rate it, you can look at the cast and credits, all that sort of stuff. And of course, you can press the button here and rent it. Now, I'm not going to rent it at this stage, but you can see what I'm talking about because it's going to be fairly similar to what we saw from the apps and books, etc. Now, other things you can do with this is we've got a little search up here. So, say for example, I want to pull up other apps. I might already know the name of it because I might have seen this. Now, I know one called Pulse. This is a kind of newsreader application that I want to download. And again, it gives you anything that comes up in the apps, the books, the movies, depending on where you are within the Android market. I want the application there. It immediately jumps you to this, gives you the same information we saw before. Again, I can install. And again, it's following a similar pattern. Now, you don't actually have to wait while this is installing in this screen. You can jump back to kind of your home screen. It will carry on downloading, and it will let you know in the kind of notifications when it's downloaded. And you can actually see at the top here some of these icons that are appearing, which are shortcuts to anything you've downloaded. And we've looked in previous videos at how you can kind of configure those shortcuts so they're a bit easier for you to find or set it out exactly as you want to. But those are now downloaded, and again, if you want to lose those applications, it's just a case of clicking on them and you can start using them. So that's it really for the Android market. I'm just going to check whether there's anything else I want to show you here. There's a kind of various shortcuts that tell you what you've downloaded. There's other bits here that you can look at: account settings, help screens, all this sort of stuff. But there's nothing really hugely else. There's another option here actually, which is sharing. So if you find an app you really like and you want to share it with someone else, either via Skype, Google+, Gmail, email, Bluetooth, all that sort of stuff, it's all possible. But I won't go into any more detail on that. So that's it for the Android market. We'll come back, I'm sure, and use this again in future videos to download applications and books, etc. But you can see what it's capable of. So we'll come back to you in future videos showing you more on how to use your Android tablet PC.